China descended into utter chaos as multiple Red Armies came up and were taking on each other. The armies and their cadre all were driven by loyalty to Mao and Mao alone, not to the party. As goals kept shifting, the revolution changed from identifying capitalist tendencies to purging the Communist Party itself. Mao had unleashed a social revolution at an unprecedented scale, where young people were asked to denounce the CCP party members.
A religion whose Bible in China is the little red book of Mao's quotations. Instead of the icons and statues of Christianity, there is Mao in white plaster and cheerful paint. Instead of medals, there are buttons to be worn on the jacket. Like a Roman religious procession, pictures are carried at the head of marching bands of youths, Red Guards or peasants. This new religion demands total faith, total obedience. And in return, it promises that miracles will be accomplished. And the masses believe it.
Martial law became the only way to rein in the Red Guards. As the army took control of all aspects of life, widespread persecution followed. In Guangdong alone, over 40,000 people were killed or died due to brutal torture. But China's devastation moved few. Since Western elites were experimenting with communist ideals, they considered China as the epitome of class struggle. Many denounced the Beatles' hit song Revolution for its portrayal of Chairman Mao. You better free your mind instead. But if you go carrying pictures of Chairman Mao, you ain't gonna make it with anyone anyhow. And it is unlikely that John Lennon would have worn the Mao badge in 1971 if he knew the sheer scale of human catastrophe that took place under Mao's watch. During this period, Mao was the final authority and made all decisions in China, although he often allowed for debate. As he rolled out the ill-conceived Cultural Revolution, the top party hierarchy lived in abject fear of Chairman Mao. One such instance was the first Central Committee plenum of the Ninth Party Congress in 1969, where Chairman Mao could not even convince a single leader to express their opinion.
Old Dong won't talk. Who will talk? Come on, this is a Politburo meeting. Be a little democratic. I have nothing new to say. Well, shall we continue the meeting? You all won't talk.
That's about it. Then let's end the meeting.
This was Mao's model that later came to define the iron fist that dictated how top Chinese leaders ran their country, with unquestioned authority. Mao purged his political rivals or those who questioned his irrational decisions. These included the former premier Liu Shaoqi, who was expelled from the party since he questioned the Cultural Revolution. Parallels can be drawn to the present period under Xi Jinping, where political rivals like Bo Qilai and Chao Yongkang have been given life imprisonment. They crossed Xi's path and were ostensibly caught in the anti-corruption campaign.
Today, people look at the disaster of the Maoist years and say, oh, Mao is just an aberration. Then they say that Deng Xiaoping normalized politics, institutionalized the Communist Party, put China on a better path. But today, we also have another Mao-like strongman, Xi Jinping. So it looks like strongman, one-man rule is really the norm for the Communist Party, which idealizes struggle. And it looks like the Deng years are really the aberration. And so we have to understand the nature of Chinese communism, and it is more like Mao than it is like Deng.
But that wasn't all. These images bear testimony to how Mao Zedong treated both dissent and dissenters under his tenure. These images and graphic videos are of Laogai, Chinese concentration camps that were built by Mao Zedong during the 1950s. As many as 1,000 concentration camps were built across China, which were modeled on the Russian Gulag, where forced labor was the order of the day. Mao Zedong was inspired by fellow comrade and strongman Joseph Stalin to build Laogai to deal with what he felt was unlawful and unjustified dissent against the state. Since China does not allow any access to Laogai, such reports came out much later by those who were able to survive the ordeal and narrate it to the global audience. In 1994, China was forced to rename these labor camps as re-education centers. But the practice continues unabated. Xi Jinping has used these very concentration camps to keep large population in the Xinjiang region under detention centers. Mao Zedong normalized brutal crackdown against Chinese citizens and Chinese people. Both Deng Xiaoping and Xi Jinping also built on Mao's methods of dealing with China's neighbors. While Deng Xiaoping led the unprovoked assault on Vietnam in 1979, Xi Jinping has created tensions in the South China Sea by laying claim to Vietnamese waters. Both followed Mao, who played a key role in the fight against Americans in Korea and Vietnam. But later developed a unique love-hate relationship. This was particularly true for Vietnam, where there was more hate than love over time. Mao Zedong harbored ambitions of ruling Vietnam by proxy, though he shaped the communist regime in North Vietnam by providing arms, ammunition, logistics, and other help. He desired a much larger role in the region, which Ho Chi Minh, the powerful Vietnamese leader, was not in favor of. In 1954, at the end of the First Vietnam War, at the Geneva Accords, Mao even provided $100 million to North Vietnam. But none of this deterred Ho Chi Minh for keeping and preserving his country's sovereignty. Over time, this has set the stage for how China deals with its neighbors, as a bully who towers over smaller countries. A format that has only been perfected by Xi Jinping with time. All his life, Chairman Mao tried to avoid Stalin's fate. But in the end, the two dictators witnessed fall from grace, though Chairman Mao's fall was less steep. Soon after his death, Deng Xiaoping announced that the country's founder was wrong almost a third of his period in office. He highlighted the ideological and political mistakes that were committed by the great helmsman. Within a month of his death, Mao's widow was put behind bars for crimes committed during the Cultural Revolution. Though Deng didn't tarnish Mao's legacy like Khrushchev vilified Stalin, generations of Chinese have now been indoctrinated to think that Mao's track record in office was just 70-30. The demaoization of China started with the embrace of capitalism and jettisoning of Mao's bland economy.
On every May Day, on each October 1st, the national anniversary, a 500,000 of them obediently line up in numbered places to cheer Mao atop the huge gate. Then for hours, they parade through the square, a riot of Chinese color. Tiananmen holds a special place for Mao. From August to December 1966, he appeared there before 11 million forcefully cheering Chinese to kick off the Cultural Revolution. Today,
in the next episode, we explain how China rose to become the world's second largest economy. Deng Xiaoping became the architect of modern China. And as the author of China's Heidenberg Doctrine, Deng ushered in the era of SEZs. But in true Mao style, Deng also ordered troops to shoot unarmed students at the Tiananmen Square.